mind control ability. Is it here? On November 30th, Neuralink, one of Elon Musk's companies, held a flashy recruiting event called Show and Tell, sharing the latest advances of the company. The event showcased a video that Musk said showed a monkey using a brain implant to control a cursor and type on a computer, writing sentences and even playing Pong game. The event presented also the engineering solutions and development in Neuralink. Musk said the company submitted most of its documents for FDA approval and expects human trials in 6 months. Whether Musk's timing is gonna happen or not, this is still amazing news for the technology and for the company. But wait, where did Neuralink came from and what exactly are they working on? Here is a quick reminder. Neuralink was founded in 2016 by Musk and a group of scientists. It strives to develop brain-computer interface, or BCIs, that connect the human brain to computers that can decipher neural signals called spikes. Neuralink wants to connect the machines to a human brain. Basically, in short terms, Neuralink hopes to connect digital computers with the human brain, so humans will be able to control them only by thinking of it. How is it supposed to work? In a nutshell, our brain is composed of neurons, cells that are built to transfer electrical potential. The electrical signals travel through the cell until its end at a gap called synapse. There, the electrical potential becomes a chemical signal called neurotransmitters. This channeling of information and signals goes through billions of cells for every memory you recall or a muscle you move. Keep in mind, your brain is composed of 100 billion neuron cells. It is a massive network of signal highways. Once we understand neurons use electrical pulses to connect all its areas and transfer commands from cell to cell, we know there is lots of electrical activity in our brain. Electrical activity generates electrical fields, which we know how to measure. Measuring electrical fields and their strength, we can collect bits of data and form patterns and use algorithms to make sense of those signals and know what they actually mean. The signals have a unique sound to them. This reading of neuron signals is supposed to happen using a chip called Link, only 8 millimeters wide. This chip contains 1,024 channels. Each channel is an electrode collecting the potential spike data. 16 electrodes are connected to a thread, each thread only a few blood cells wide. 64 of those threads exit the Link unit. The threads are so small, Neuralink took a unique approach. A key part of Neuralink's approach is a surgical robot designed to drop electrodes into the brain, steering past blood vessels to avoid bleeding and scarring the brain tissue. Once it's installed, the device can send and receive electrical signals from the brain's neurons. The device will be able to collect data on the brain's activity and work patterns, but more than that, the device will provide you with control over other devices and machines and sort of make you the AI-human hybrid. You will be theoretically capable of swiping on a dating app without moving your fingers. You will be able to control the lighting of your smart home just with the power of brain signals. The possibilities are endless and open a hatch to unique superpowers you might see in superhero movies, but more realistically help the paralyzed and people suffering from neurological diseases like epilepsy, Alzheimer, and more. As Musk said, the limbic area is the most basic and primal part of the brain, while the cortex is more planning and analyzing part, and its size is unique to us humans. Neuralink working on the third layer, which provides us with endless opportunities. Musk's technology is also meant to make us more symbiotic with future AI robots. Musk hopes that with this path, humans won't lose their competitive edge against future machines. Before this show and tell event, Neuralink already gave a taste to the public on a few of their milestones. Back in 2019, a pig named Gertrude was implanted with this device to show it functions normally during and after installation. The device monitored around 1,000 neurons of the pig. April 2021, mind pong video of Paige or a monkey playing a video game using only its mind. The joystick was used to calibrate the data from two link units in his head. After that, we can see the joystick disconnected, but Pager plays the game as nothing happened and drinking his banana smoothie as in a usual gaming session. During the event, Musk revealed that the company's first two intended applications for its technology would be to help people with paralysis to use their digital devices seamlessly and to restore vision in those who have lost their eyesight. Even if someone has never had a vision like they were born blind, we believe we can still restore vision, Musk said. The event didn't provide any significant vision restoration technology, but it did include a video demonstration of how Neuralink's implant have been used to stimulate a visual sensation. Using a light that's flashing at the monkey, the Neuralink team also demonstrated how its surgical robot inserts electrode threads, using a dummy filled with a gelatinous brain proxy material. The robot's challenge is to avoid blood vessels and doing this reliably. During the presentation, it took about 15 minutes for the robot to plant 64 threads into the dummy. We also got a glance at the wireless charging mechanisms for the device. Since the link is capable of 12 hours of work, charging is a big thing here. The event also included engineers and team leads showing advances in the implant insertion. And it was revealed that unlike previous plans connecting the chip under the dura layer, the company actually strives to place the implant above the dura layer right under the skull. On a Q&A during the event, Musk said they will open source some of the datasets they have collected. This device has its fair share of criticism. First of all, though hopes are to start clinical trials in 6 months, one needs to remember the Link is Class 3 medical device. The FDA takes a hard line with this kind of devices. Moreover, no such devices were tested on humans before. Neuralink was actually planning to perform human trials in 2020. So we can see they are still working on this goal. Other challenges include interfacing with billions of neurons effectively. The implant was also never tested for a few years of experiment. And it's also supposed to avoid triggering our immune system rejection. Engineers need to make the implant survivable in the chemical conditions of the brain, like humidity, which is a challenge, of course, for all electronic devices. The core idea behind Neuralink brings up numerous ethical and sociopolitical questions, but proponents say such devices provide life-changing help to amputees and disabled persons if they, for example, lose the ability to use their hands or see. Curing paralysis or restoring vision, the applications are amazing, but many do skeptical about the technology and especially timetable the company hopes for. Some scientists claim it's still unclear how the link will work under real-life conditions and whether we have enough scientific data and know-how to operate the next smartphone with our heads alone. It looked like Neuralink is working at a fast pace with one goal in mind: clinical human trials as fast as possible. We can easily think about a future when this technology will be for everyone's use. Until then, we will follow the test success and challenges of this industry. And who knows? Maybe you will watch your future videos by clicking play with your mind. We work hard to bring you great content. So if you like the video, subscribe and share the video with your other tech-savvy friends. Thank you for watching.